a psycho. Lil' mama bad like Michael. Can't really trust nobody with all this jewelry on you. My roof look like a show. Got diamonds.
Jacob599 asked, I think from Instagram, how can I gain weight? I'm struggling with putting on weight. Oh yeah, I remember this guy. So, like I said before, it's all to do with your calories and the amount you're eating and the amount you're burning as far as calories. So some people have a really hard time gaining weight, and that's often because the more they eat, the more that when they're sitting there, they'll start doing these ones and twitching and looking around and exercising more, just because that's the way their body works, right? It's called NEAT. So basically, when you eat food, that upregulates in some people. And when you don't eat food, like when you're in a calorie deficit, that downregulates in some people, and some people turn into sloths and just chill out on the couch all day. And that offsets the calorie deficit that your body's trying to balance back out again, because our bodies always want to be in a happy spot. So they're not comfortable with going through these changes. So you gotta force it, and you gotta make sure that you've got every variable tracked and managed so that you get the result that you want. If you're eating 6,000 calories and you're not gaining weight, eat 7,000 calories. Like, just pick up the food. Obviously, your food choices have got to be foods that are more calorically dense versus me, who I'm cutting at the moment. Well, I'm still eating a nice amount of food. I've got to choose those food sources properly so that I don't get too hungry. So that's where you resort to more cleaner foods, just because they're lower in calories by nature and they're more filling, more satiating. All right, so I hope that helps, mate. You're in a nice predicament than being on the other end of the spectrum, that's for sure. Where do you live? Where are you from? So I live in Adelaide, which is in Australia. I'm originally a country boy from Port Lincoln in South Australia. If you don't know where that is, if I'm any good, I can put up a thing just here. If I'm not, Google it, all right? Help me lean up. What do I do? What do I need to do? So, I've already pretty much covered that. You need to be tracking your variables. You need to either be working out how much you're eating or working out how much you're exercising, and messing around with those, either increasing them or decreasing them to get the result that you're after. If you need me personally to go over those kinds of things, I can. That's what I'm here for. That's what my PT business is going to be, as far as helping people get started on those goals. But I want to get them started as quick as possible, get them independent, and then look, I'm just here to help. So what services do you offer? So at the moment, I've got the 2 weeks of free consultations. So it's just face-to-face consultations. I can give you guys a call. We can sort things out like that. I'm still finalizing my pricings as far as like actual PT sessions. And then my programs online, I'm still finalizing those as well. But I'm going to have a lot of free content online that will lead into the paid services, so that if people aren't sure about things, you can try things out. And look, it's just there to benefit you in the first place. So go for it as far as taking advantage of all the free stuff that I'm going to be offering. And then when you see the paid prices, you know, just have a chat, and we can sort things out from there. When can I train with you? It's a tricky one. Now that I've got a gym space opening up, if you don't want to train in your own gym or at a Good Life or a main franchise gym, then I've got a private space that we can hit up pretty much any time. So that's pretty flexible, actually. Have you kept much strength on your cut? So as far as my numbers currently, that I know to the best of my ability, because I'm not going to max out at the moment. It's too hard to recover from when I'm in a deficit. So like the other night, for example, I hit 260 times 8 on the squat. I'm still deadlifting 200 for sets of 8. And benching over 100 for sets of 7 the other night. And all of these strength numbers, while they might not be at peak, are still not far off of that, which I'm very happy with, for considering that I've lost 10 kilos, which if you look at that as far as powerlifting, as in power to ratio, like definitely made my ratios as far as powerlifting and strength goes a lot better losing that weight. Because I'm feeling good, still feeling pretty strong and looking better for it every day, so it's all good. Hey man, I'm doing a cut and my weight has stalled. What should I do now? My calories are already pretty damn low. So this is a bit of a tricky question, because you mainly need to think about your priorities. Like, if your priority is just getting really, really shredded, like, so, hey man, I'm doing a cut and my weight has stalled. What should I do now? My calories are already pretty low. So this is a bit of a tricky question, and it's tricky because you got to think of your priorities, right? If you've cut a lot of weight, you've been aggressive maybe, and you've gotten to a point where your calories are too low, is it really worth suffering that much to bring them down even further, to burn those extra calories? Have you got, like, at the moment, are you not doing any cardio? Like, you can increase your cardio and that shouldn't have too much of an impact if you don't want to take away from food. But sometimes you just reach a point during a fat loss phase where you've got to accept, right, for where I am at in my lifting career, with the amount of muscle that I've got, maybe I can't get as lean as I should be able to or will be able to further on down the line. So the best approach for you might be increasing food slightly, which you may see a weight drop anyway from dropping diet fatigue. But I'd increase the weight slowly over the next few months, and in 6 months' time, if you're looking better, feeling better, and you're progressing in the gym, you're building more muscle, then have another run at losing fat again if you get your calories back into a healthy point. But once your calories reach a certain point that they're too low, you can't keep digging and digging. There's no minus 1,000 calories. It doesn't work like that. So if they are at that point where weight loss is stalled and they're way too low, then look at upping them. Look at increasing performance in the gym. Look at actually gaining more muscle, because more muscle, more tissue, it takes more calories to feed, and you use it as ammunition during a cutting phase. The bigger you are, the more calories you're going to need, the easier you're going to find it to lose that body fat and maintain a lower body fat over time. So while I'm younger, my goal is to keep pushing up in weights as much as I can, without getting too heavy. That's what this mini cut was for, just to bring myself back down. But so that come back in 2-3 years, I've gained a lot more size than I would have if I tried to gain really, really, really slowly. And at that point, then I'll look at maintaining a leaner physique year round, and I should be on a lot higher calories as well. That's the goal anyway. So that was 11 questions. I've got a couple of other like paragraph questions which I'm gonna definitely answer, but I'm gonna look to do that in a longer format. Okay, so I'll probably do individual YouTube videos for those questions, and just so I can give those questions the depth that they deserve. So anyway, cheers guys. I hope you got something out of this. If you did, like the video on whatever format this is on. You can follow me on any of my other outlets so that you can ask your own questions, and we can all learn, and I can put these questions up, and hopefully it helps some people out. So cheers guys, I'll talk to you later. I tell that 4, 5 to 5th. 100 bins inside my short to chino the shit.
Ay, try to stuff it on in, but it don't even fit. Ay, know that I've been with the shits ever since the jit. Ay, I made my first million, I'm like shit.